Hi there. Just want to give you a really quick tour of some elements of a SharePoint site. So a lot of people are using SharePoint as part of that place to store information for their files that integrate with Microsoft Teams. And so if we look at SharePoint itself, let's just see what else it has other than files. So I'm going to take you through a couple of sample sites of mine so you can see the different elements within the site. So this one is called Work Remotely. And as you can see at the top, there's always, these are like templated styles, by the way, and then you can edit the template and add a lot more. But let's just talk about the different elements here. So we have news area, we have a links area. So this links to various places. These are actually different websites. And then this is the Facebook group. You have an area for documents, and then it's an area to see activity, who's opened what file. You can add in pictures and you can add in previews to documents so people can look at the document right on the site as well. And all of this, this whole page right here, could be linked right into Teams or any part of this page. Well, I shouldn't say any part of this page. Certain parts of this page could be linked to Teams as well. Now, on this particular site example, I have a tech tips page. So I'm just going to go there. And I want you to just see that on this page, really what's happening is there's two document libraries. So there's this one and there's this one. And that's important to note because that's something that can help me organize who can see what files in my Teams app. And it also helps me organize who can see what page in the SharePoint app as well. All right, so this is in the Work Remotely site. I'm going to go now back to SharePoint and just the homepage for my account. And I just want you to see, I have a lot of sites. A lot of them are samples for my training. Some of them are real sites though. And I'm gonna go to the next example I wanted to show you was Mission Office. And within this site, looks a little bit similar, but the different elements here are contact lists. So you can actually have lists living right in the site as opposed to you having to open up a spreadsheet to show information. So it's kind of like the on the bulletin board effect. People have stuff on or around their desk for a list of name and numbers that they have to contact. And that might be internal numbers and stuff like that. So that's what these lists are. And then what else is different on this particular page is there's a gallery of pictures and there's even a live stream of the recent tweets that we've done. Here's another example of a site that you could have on SharePoint. This one's a lot more visual. And these pictures here could actually lead to other pages or to other websites or wherever you want to link them to. So if I go into the working from home picture, that takes me to another page on this particular site that just has documents on it and some the document activity as well. This site has a toolbar at the top that let me go to different pages, one of them being Microsoft Office, which again is another page that just has a list on it and some links and just a picture and documents again. So there's way more than this that you can do on a SharePoint site, but I just wanted to show you a few basics that are available to you on a SharePoint site, and then some of them that will definitely apply to your Teams program. On this particular site example, I'm going to show you the calendar that can be tied in, a group calendar that can be tied into your SharePoint site that can then show up on your Teams app as well. So this is a site page in the SharePoint site for the group calendar for this group. And these are the upcoming appointments or events on that calendar. And this can be shown within the Teams tab. Okay, so a few different ideas for you of how a site can look and some other elements of a site that can appear in your Teams app. So the calendar page, your different document pages coming from different document libraries. And so in putting together your SharePoint site, keep these things in mind because this can really help with how good your team site is going to look, right? And how flexible it is for the people that are on the different teams and in the different channels. All right, so hopefully that gives you some ideas of how to put things together, and you can go to work making some plans for how you want it to look. Thanks.